This production contains extremely explicit content. Listen far from children.
Hello there, and welcome to another exciting episode of the new SEXTAMENT on Primus Radio. I am your host, it's the Y to the E to the E to the Z and A. If you're just joining us or tuning in for the first time, yay! You're super welcome to the family and to our regular listeners. We love and appreciate you so much. Thank you for the support. Thank you for staying here. Thank you for listening. Also, do not forget to like, subscribe, and share with your family. You can also drop me a comment in the comment section. Sometime this one of these weeks, I will make time and reply all your questions. Don't worry about that. I got you. Okay, so without wasting more time, this week on the show, I will be sharing with you the hidden secrets of your partner's body. That's right, you heard right. I'm going to be talking to you about everything you need to know about the erogenous zone. What are the erogenous zones? The erogenous zones are those places that, you know, make you feel extra, you know, good when it's touched, etc. All right. So, this week, as I said, I'm going to be telling you the four unexpected hot spots of your body. Like, you didn't expect that they were part of the equation. But, well, that's where you're wrong. They are. And then three familiar areas. This ones you already probably know about, but you just don't know how to work your way around them. And then three more below the belt. Don't worry, like, you didn't know these parts existed. Well, you probably did, but you did. Yeah, I'm pretty sure majority of people don't know these parts existed, and that's why I'm here. I'm here to bring you information that you didn't know about and teach you what to do. All right. You know, we all have erogenous zones, but everyone's different. Like, of course, I've always said, human beings, especially women, what works for me might not work for the next lady and all of that. So we already know this. So that's all. We've already figured out, established that you may not feel all that tingly goodness in the same areas as some other person. So, yeah. That said, you likely have more of the spots than you already know. Well, stay tuned to find out which touch points could use a little more TLC. And by TLC, I mean tender loving care. Alright, real quick, I'm going to go on a short musical break. And when I return, I'll be jumping straight into the four unexpected hotspots I didn't know existed. Stay tuned.
Somebody will go treat you right. Respect a woman like you said you need somebody. Somebody will go dry your eyes. Whenever you cry, I say you need somebody. Hey, don't you need someone like me? Don't you need someone like me?
Welcome back, guys. All right, before I went on that short musical break, I was saying that when I return, I was going to be talking to you about the four unexpected hot spots in the body you didn't know were there. Well, you probably already knew this one, this particular one, but it comes as a shocker, because it's just weird. How does behind the knee sound? Yeah. So the number one thing, the first unexpected hotspot is the scalp. Yeah, the scalp is full of nerve endings, like a lot of it, and even the slightest brush of hair can send tingles through the body. You know, when someone just puts his fingers in your hair and just runs it through your scalp, oh my goodness. Especially if you just finish making your hair, because for the ladies that make your hair in the beauty, like, it just feels good, like, come on, for power, Lori. Same thing for the guys, you know, when you're rubbing his head and all of that, it's really, really nice. And to amp up that pleasure, I would say you should run your fingernails lightly over the scalp, paying attention to the space behind the ears and just above the neck. You're going to thank me later, I promise. Alright, the second unexpected hotspot on the body is behind the knee. Yes, behind the knee. This is another often neglected area. Like, people don't even think about it because they don't know what is there. It's incredibly sensitive to absolutely any kind of touch. It's even ticklish for some people. Like, if you touch them there, they can't control themselves. It's going to start laughing. That's how sensitive it is. So you can give this some special attention during massage, or use your mouth and tongue there for it before working your way up all of the leg. You know, just a little bit of extra when you're doing it. It comes out. You can never go wrong. Well, the truth is, when it comes to erogenous zones, it's not just about the nips, knobs, and slits. Trust me, it's a whole lot more. That's why I'm here telling you all of this. Okay, the number three unexpected hotspot on the body is the small of the back. You know, it's just below the back and your waist. Yeah, just like slightly above your bum, your bum bone. Down there, the sacrum, that's where. So here, it could probably have something to do with the fact that the nerves in this area of the spine are, like, connected to the pelvis, or the vulnerability factor of being touched from behind that makes this area so sensitive. And I don't know, I'll never be able to figure it out, but whatever it is, the slightest touch here can evoke pleasure. Just tickle the area with your lips and tongues, you know, just do something extra. And if you're feeling really adventurous, you could use an ice cube or a vibrator, something for some sensory play. I don't know, the choice is yours, really. Just, it depends on how kinky you want to get. Alright, moving on to the fourth unexpected hotspot is the inner wrist. This is the home of the pulse point, yes, and it's not used to getting a lot of action. The inner wrist is highly sensitive, as some of you may not know. It is really sensitive. So what you do right for me is, when you're with your partner, just caress the skin with your fingertips while looking at your partner suggestively. It is really sexy, especially if you had a dinner date or something, and then you just grab their hands and then you're slightly working your hands around their, you know, their wrist, and you're playing with it and all of that. It's really sexy. Real quick, I'm gonna go on another short musical break, and when I return, we're going to be discussing the three familiar areas you already know and the three more below the belt you didn't know about. Stay tuned.
From the start, you were a thief, you stole my heart, and I, your willing victim. I let you see the parts of me that weren't all that pretty, and with every touch you fixed them. Now you've been talking in your sleep, things you never say to me. Just give me a reason, just a little bit enough.
So I'm going to be discussing the three familiar areas. All right. Well, this is pretty obvious. That's why I call it familiar areas. That's the areola and nipples. This is the first familiar area I'm going to be talking about. Like, it's nipple stimulation lights up the same area in the brain as the genitals. I swear, it just comes on. All right, so you're going to want to start with a light touch, and anything goes here. It could be your lips, it could be your tongue, it could be a feather or a small vibrator. See, these are just a few ideas. You can go crazy with it. Whatever works for you and your partner. Just try to do really, really light strokes around it. Trace, bring her to the edge, take her back. You know, just blow. Take your time and do some really sexy, cool stuff. Yep, and if your partner likes it rough, okay, you can introduce your teeth into the mix, but gently. We don't want to chew them off now, do we? And if they're really super into more of a things, then you can get nipple clamps. Those are really fun. Trust me, I know. Alright, another one is the neck. When it comes to the neck, even the slightest touch can make your entire body tingle. We all know this is true. Wrap your arms around your partner and run your fingernails along the back of your neck, moving to the area behind the ears before making your way around to the front. Move on softly, kissing the sides on the front. Just do crazy things with that neck. Be gentle, be really super gentle. And now finally, the inner thighs. The inner thighs are super sensitive and are so close to the ultimate erogenous zone. That even just a grease can set your lungs ablaze. I swear, just a grease of your inner thighs could make you go crazy. I'm speaking for the women right now, I don't know about the men, but anyways, when you're ready to get up close and personal, blanket the area in a soft, wet kisses and licks. You're welcome. Alright, the three more below the belt. The three more erogenous zones below the belt. The first obvious one, the clitoris. Yeah, duh. What were you expecting to hear? Alright, so there's the clit, and then there's the G-spot and P-spot. I say G-spot and P-spot because the women have G-spot and then the men have P-spot. But then it's not like you can't find P-spot in women too, but it's basically for the men because they're the ones with posture. So the P-spot, is, I think I spoke about this in the last episode that I recorded, so I'm just going to talk about the G-spot because we already know about the clitoris, don't we? Or should I just say, okay, let me see something. The clitoris is I've recorded a couple of things about the clitoris, so if you want to know, just listen to the previous episodes. Sorry. The G-spot is an area that's capable of causing what is known as female ejaculation. We already know this. And it is located up and deep inside the vagina. Yes, I said it. With a good amount of lubricant, I beg your pardon, turn on your vibrator or your finger upward toward the navel and move in the confident, like, come forward motion. When you put your finger up in the vagina and you do it, and you slightly bend your fingers as if you're making a gesticulation to somebody to come forward. Yeah, that's the one. That's the